Peace and blessings. This is Queen Ifama. I am the truth seeker. And I'm doing this as a response video. And I just want to say, and this is about the Shug as a manipulator and the addressing particularly what patriarchy is. And, you know, brother, I agree. We are not going to agree on whether Shug was a manipulator or not, because I still contend that she was not a manipulator in the book nor in the movie. I have a clear understanding of what a manipulator is. Okay, and I think, and I'm just going to say this, is I think that a lot of times we can be blinded by our prejudices. And I do think that you have formed prejudices against feminists, what, you know, women who call themselves feminists, or, you know, any form that could be you know, possibly construed as a feminism. So I think that kind of blinds you to a reality, and I don't know how you came to the conclusion that she was a manipulator, because you didn't give me any clear instance of her actually manipulating anybody from the definition of what a manipulator is. I didn't get any clear definition of her actual manipulation. Okay, because manipulation is a sort of power, and I didn't see her utilizing, you know, power manipulation as a power, you know, base or power form in the movie or in the book. So I'm really, you know, I was kind of baffled. That's why I even responded to the video, because I was kind of baffled as where you would get that from, where she was a manipulator. But anyway, that aside, I just wanted to, you know, give my points on that. But as far as patriarchy being a theory, it is far from a theory. And if you know what a damn theory is, you know, that's just like something that hasn't been able, people haven't been able to actually concrete, or they would say, well, you know, this is a possibility that this is what's happening, you know. And then to throw up those four white women as an example of this not being a patriarchal society, that was unbelievable. That's just like white people pulling up Obama, saying that, see, y'all got a black president. I don't know why y'all whining now. Why is everything's the same instance? You can't give me no four examples and make that stick for everybody. That just don't work for me. Okay, now, you know, as far as patriarchy has been on the planet for thousands of years, and patriarchy is a form of a social system, okay, where there's dominance and hierarchy, and it's not so much as the benefits of that's, you know, generated from you know, a patriarch. It's the patriarchy is all about the assignment of status in the society. And historically, women have been categorized as less than men on the social ladder. Okay, I mean, there is no, and you can't even fucking deny that. Okay, it's only recently where the women's rights, you know, fight has elevated women to another level. But I would say, you know, like maybe even as less as 200 years ago, women were way down on the social ladder. Now, they may have wielded some individual powers within their homes with their husbands or whatever, but at the end of the day, it is about status in the society. It's about ranking of superiority and inferiority. That's what patriarchy is all about, and the privileges that go along with that. Now, as you know, you brought up what was that, one of them archies? Or, damn, I can't remember. What did you say? That is a, I don't know. Did you say it was an oligarchy? That is more, it could be more considered an oligarchy instead of patriarchal. Or It could be plutocratic, but one term, since we're throwing out words that other people have, you know, given, you know, this particular situation that we're in as men and women, is there's a word called chiriarchy, another fucking archy, okay? And because the patriarchy, according to this, because of the limited capacity of the word patriarchy to describe the full operation of interacting or intersecting oppressions, you hear that, don't you? Some now prefer to use the word chiriarchy. That's K-Y-R-I-A-R-C-H-Y instead, but it's not commonly used so far. So let's look at what does the word chiriarchy mean. Boy, these people are killing me. Chiriarchy means, well, it's a neologism that was coined by Elizabeth Schutzler Fiorenza and derived from the Greek that's a Freudian slip, from the Greek words for Lord or Master, Krios. Master means Krios in Greek. Master or Lord means Krios. And to rule or dominate is Archean. So, which seeks to redefine the analytic category of patriarchy in terms of multiplicative intersecting structures of domination. Chiriarchy is best theorized as a complex pyramidal system of intersecting, and I would say multiplying social structures of superordination or higher ranking and subordination, which is lower ranking of ruling and oppression. And patriarchy literally means the rule of the father and is generally understood within feminist discourses in a dualistic sense as asserting the domination of all men over women in equal terms. The theoretical adequacy of patriarchy has been challenged because, for instance, black men did not have control over white women or white men, and some women, whether they were slave or mistresses, did have power over lower ranking women and men. And that's just true. And so that's probably why the controversy of it is. But at the end of the day, it is the social ranking of the genders that constitutes for me what patriarchy is. And not only that, in, you know, patriarchy basically, as I, you know, think about it even more, patriarchy is only based on male strength. It's only based on this physical strength disparity between men and women, and that this is a sign that says that the woman is naturally inferior to the male because she doesn't have the strength of the male. So that makes her naturally inferior, where she could be physically subdued by the male. But fortunately, there are men who, you know, protect women against that to a degree, and even to the point where, after much friction, we've been able to get laws that protect women from the physical onslaught of men, because men historically have used their physical and brute strength against women to get them to kowtow to their demands. And that's another form of using force as power. And if you look at the topology of power, you'll see that there's several levels of power. Like, there's force as power, there's coercion as power, there's a manipulation as power, there's influences power. So there's various different types of power that can be used, whereas force is probably the least because of the agitation that will occur as a result of it, which is why, you know, I assert now why we have laws where you can't just go and be whooping nobody's ass just because you mad. And I'm gonna tell you, that's what prohibition, that's what brought about the fight for prohibition years ago. I just got through looking at a documentary about that. It's because these men men will go out and get drunk and come home and terrorize their damn families. Okay, so they, you know, for the sake of the family is why they began the fight against to have prohibition to stop, you know, men from, you know, using alcohol and then coming in and taking shit out on their families. So, you know, patriarchy is not basically all about the benefits one receives, but it's the privilege that one has to physically dominate you. Okay, and then again, not only that, even if they use the other forms of power like manipulation or coercion or whatever, there's always that element of force that can be used because they got that in their back pocket. Okay, so if you don't do this by manipulation, if you don't do this by coercion, or if you don't do this by influencing, damn, we can come in with force. So, you know, that's kind of like even, and Dr. Amos Wilson really goes into those typologies of power in his book called Blueprint for Black Power. But I'm saying is that patriarchy is very real. It is definitely not a fucking theory. It's concrete and it's real and it's in your face. That's just like saying a white supremacy is a theory. Okay. That ain't no theory. That's in your face. It's the same thing. You know, but if you're not a victim of it, then you can't see it. And that's clearly been shown by everybody who has an opposition to what we call white supremacy or, you know, white dominant power in the society. Those who aren't affected by it don't see it. They take advantage of it, whether it's on purpose or not. It's there for them to take advantage of. And that's the same thing with the system of patriarchy. It is a system. I just want to put that on record. It's a system that's even older than white supremacy. I think I've done a video on this before. But, you know, like, you know, we were saying, you know, I appreciate your commentary. You have your views. I have my views. You know, I just don't think that patriarchy is a damn theory. I think it's a fucking fact. And I think it's in our faces, particularly those of us who are subjects of it. It's in our face, you know. And the thing about it is, as long as you have the human psychology that exists today, that, you know, I can get what I want and use the last measurement of force, then you're going to have that type of system going on and people are going to be oppressed. But the only thing is you go have kickback. That's the only thing with any type of suppressive system that suppresses a group, whether it's white supremacy, whether it's patriarchy, whether it's matriarchy, which is why I did a video on matriarchy and the fact that it, you know, supposedly there was a matriarchal system. Did men feel oppressed under a matriarchal system? You know, is that why we now have a patriarchal system? Is that the matriarchal system was overthrew, you know, by men because they felt a certain kind of way? So anytime you have a system that's an archy and somebody's at the top of it, you're going to always have problems in society. That's my point. I don't know if there's even a such thing as governance of a society without rulership in a society, because it seems to me from, you know, my studies is that people that are put in a position to rule, to govern, often becomes the rulers. And to me, that's the fault of the people, because the people begin to hold them up like God and give them all the power when the power resides in the people at the end of the day. And people having a quote unquote democratic mindset, whereas we vote on whatever we want. And if you lose, you just take the loss. Simple as that. Majority rules. I mean, that makes sense to me. You know what I'm saying? Or either you break off and you take your little group and go someplace else, you know, instead of agitating in the group that decided this is what we want. And I do believe too that is how we got so many tribes and, you know, groups of people, is that people did break off because of disagreement. You know what I'm saying? I just think that's how we all come to be what we are and who we are, is that And that's why I think disagreement is part of human nature. And that's something that we have to take a look at. You know, and another thing I wanted to really press is our prejudice. You know, we could develop prejudices against people that would cloud our ability to see things that just make sense. But because we have a prejudice, it blinds us from actually being able to, look at things in a, more open way. So anyway, I just did this little short video just to, respond to your video as you responded to mine, and to give you my thoughts on the system called patriarchy. It is definitely not a theory, in my opinion. You know, it is alive and it is kicking as long as, you have designated things that women are supposed to do as opposed to what men are supposed to do, that aren't natural, like men. Now, they, Lord have mercy, there's a man saying that men can give breastfeed children. I'm like, now that went a little too far. But there are things outside of nature that women can do that are prohibited or looked down upon when a woman decides to do it, and all the flack that she has to receive when she go into these male dominated fields, from men themselves that are sometimes unbearable. You just have to read the stories of women who go into the service and the things that they have to endure under the hands of men who feel they have no right to be there, when they have just as much right to fight and want to fight for their country as any damn body else. And that's just a small example of exclusion that I speak of when we talk about gender and what women are have to endure, in this society that's basically patriarchal, that's basically ruled by men or male dominated. So, as far as I'm concerned, you could believe what you want and say what you want and listen to all those anti-feminist driven thoughts. Luckily for me, I think for myself. So I'm right here by a door, so you hear some people going by with carts and stuff. But I've really been able to figure things out for myself. You know what I'm saying? And because of my experience, my God, I wish they'd gone by. We got movers going around here. That's why you hear, I'm going to try to. I'm trying to minimize the noise because I hate a lot of background noise. You have a lot of background noise in your videos, and it's very distracting. I just want to put that on record too. But anyway, so that, that's basically what I had to say about it, and I just think that, What can I say? Because I ain't in the convincing business. I'm not trying to convince nobody to do shit. I'm just giving my opinion on the subject matter. And that's exactly what I'm doing right now. So with that said, I'm done with this subject. I have nothing else to say about it. I'm not, like I said, I ain't trying to convince you to see it my way. But I will say that I do believe that, there's some prejudice against feminist. Period. And that's what I see as far as your input is concerned, and I think you're clouded by your prejudices. That's what I think. To call patriarchy a theory, please get out of here. I don't know too many women that'll call it a theory, okay? But that's because they're the subjects of it. So with that said, this is Queenie Farmer. I am the truth seeker. I'm out of here. Peace, everybody.